Pakistan!
Today, we reaffirm our resolve to uphold Pakistan's ideology and make Pakistan an ideal anniversary of Pakistan. On the joyous occasion of 75th anniversary of Pakistan's independence, I extend my heartiest felicitations to the entire nation.
Was not less than a miracle that started.
My acknowledgement to First Nations peoples whose land we're on and who never ceded sovereignty to this land. But I also pay respect to the broader Pakistani diaspora and community in Australia, who are some of the strongest advocates for global human rights. And we're seeing human rights around the globe come under significant threat from increasingly authoritarian regimes, whether it's in South Asia or potentially in other parts of the West. And when we see this threat of authoritarianism, the actions that we've seen of the Indian government against Jammu and Kashmir, it's important that we build global alliances for human rights. And I've got to say, the advocacy that I've seen from the Pakistani government and the Pakistani people in particular, to never allow the human rights of Jammu and Kashmir to be forgotten and to be a constant voice for the rights of those peoples, for the rights we should all have on this planet, the right to self-determination, to determine your own government and determine your own future. It is humbling to be recognised as part of that global push for the human rights, particularly the people of Jammu and Kashmir. But I also acknowledge that for Pakistan, it's a difficult part of the world to live in. Difficult neighbours, geopolitical interests seeking to cause instability and take advantage in the region. And in the face of that, Australia often forgets the burden that Pakistan has that it willingly accepts to look after, at the moment, 1.3 million Afghan refugees in the country and to provide humanitarian assistance and support. And I reflect upon Australia, how Australia would respond to an influx of refugees of anything like that order. We have huge internal debates and anger and a brutal regime to deal with 10 or 20,000 refugees. But at the same time, Pakistan opens its borders and provides humanitarian assistance with the rest of the world to 1.3 million refugees. And that's a story that should be told and heard more broadly about Pakistan's role. And I acknowledge it here today. Finish by saying this, it's happy birthday Pakistan for the 75th anniversary. It's pretty nice to be at the 75th birthday of Pakistan. And it's a particularly special day for me to receive this award. But what I hope we do is you don't just see one politician here from Australia. You see a raft of politicians in the federal parliament stand beside you whenever you're standing up for human rights, whenever you're standing up for the rights of Jammu and Kashmir, for the people of Pakistan, and for global human rights. Because for me, as a Democratic politician, as a Greens MP, a Greens senator in this parliament, human rights are a global business, and we all need to stand united in this ongoing struggle. So thank you for the award. His Excellency the High Commissioner, I know, will be travelling around the country for ceremony after ceremony after ceremony, dealt with such good grace and such dignity. High Commissioner, thank you for the award, thank you for the words. And I look forward to working together over the next years in the parliament.
Thank you.
Great what has been achieved in the 75 years since Pakistan's foundation, and to acknowledge its rich history. Each year, 14th of August, is a day to cherish connections to friends, family and culture, and to reflect with pride on the important contributions Pakistanis at home and around the world make to their nation's success. Here in Australia, we are reminded of the connections our nation share, at the heart of which is the large, vibrant and growing Australian-Pakistani community. Almost 100,000 people of Pakistani descent call Australia home. I offer my thanks for the energy and enthusiasm that you bring to serving the common good and making the country we live in a better place. To all of you, and to Pakistanis everywhere, I wish you a wonderful 75th Independence Day.
As Megan also mentioned, Australia was one of the first countries that Pakistan established diplomatic ties with. Since 1948, Australia has maintained a resident diplomatic mission in Pakistan. But the ties between Pakistan and Australia even go much beyond that. In 1912, the first Australian officer got his training at the Army Staff College, Quetta. And the first Chief of General Staff of Pakistan, Mr. McKay, General McKay, he was an Australian. So that would give you an indication of how strong the two countries have been and how strongly connected the two countries remain. Megan also mentioned the Pakistani diaspora. Let me say, it's a diaspora that is not only increasing in number, but it is also increasing in influence also. It's an extremely successful diaspora. It's a very vibrant diaspora. It's a diaspora of high achievers. We have doctors, we have engineers, we have IT professionals. We have Pakistanis now playing an increasingly important role in the socio-economic and political fabric of Australia. So please give a big round of applause for the Pakistani diaspora here in Australia. We feel tremendously proud of our diaspora here. And when we say we feel proud of our diaspora, this is because of the achievements that they have made. The Pakistani-born Australians who have attained graduation or higher degree are 52%. Now, 52% of Pakistani-born Australians have graduation or high level of education. Now, this compares to 32% among other overseas-born Australians, and 22% is the national average. So the Pakistani community with 52% is among the most highly educated Australians. The Pakistanis, again, they are a community of giving people. Coming to the human rights issue, coming to philanthropic work, coming to the community work, during the pandemic, Pakistani community here played an extremely important role in serving the community. We have among here with us Muhammad Ali, who was recently named Citizen of the Year by the government of APT. We had our doctors providing free medical treatment during COVID. We had our pharmacists providing free medicines. And then we had our students who were coming out and helping the community. I was in Melbourne, Victoria, and I met a member of the Victorian Parliament, and she told me that when I, along with my family, tested positive, it was a Pakistani gentleman who was providing us meal for the 15 days of our quarantine. But when I met that gentleman, I learned
Thank you. हमारी करना